Hello, my name is Bruce, and I'm going to show you how I stepped the mast on my Hunter 170. Here we go. We start, of course, by undoing everything that's tying the mast down from when we were trailering the boat. And then we've taken the topping lift and run it all the way past the front of the boat and into a cleat here at the trailer. This is going to be used to hold the mast up until we can get the front stay, which has a jib wrapped around it in this case, in place. Okay, we've led this end of the topping lift back here to this jib sheet cleat. We'll wrap it around it to hold it in place, but we'll show you how that works in just a second. The mast itself is pretty lightweight. A person of normal strength can lift it pretty easily. So the process is as follows. You have to move the mast back just increments at a time. Now as you move it back, you're going to get hung on some things. So as you move along, you have to check. Move your stays as necessary. Get everything freed up, then move it back a little bit more. I find lifting right here at the spreaders is a nice even point. And go ahead and let some of the weight of the mast rest here on this support and just slide it down. It's real easy. Now when you've gotten it to this point, ready to set the mast in the tabernacle. I keep a beer koozie on the end of it to keep from scratching things up. And so I am hung somewhere, and I've got to figure out where. Aha! Right here, the stay got caught in the cradle. Move this forward. Now the mast is set in the tabernacle. That done, check and make sure my topping lift is on top of everything where it needs to be, and then I just lift up on the mast, walk forward. Go ahead and push it forward until the weight is resting on the stays. Then grab your topping lift. Pull it tight, making sure that it's gotten around the spreaders. Sometimes it gets caught on the spreaders, and if it ain't tight, that ain't good. And I just take it and wrap it around the jib cleat here. Now it's made off. At that point, I'm ready to go ahead and put the front stay on, in this case, because it has furler, because it has roller furling. The jib is wrapped around the front stay. So okay, now with the front stay set, you no longer need the topping lift to hold it up. This stay is going to hold it at the front. These stays are going to hold it at the side, even though they're not tight yet. So when you do this, of course, you want to keep a hand on the mast. Rock it back. Make sure everything's set. Don't get any surprises. So now that you're at this point, that stay is pulling it from the front. These stays are pulling it from the side. Your confidence is not going to go anywhere. At that point then, you go ahead and tension the stays. First ones are easy. It's the last two that are hard, and I usually have to put my gloves on to do this. We'll see how it goes today. To do it without my gloves today. There you go. Everything's tensioned. We're now ready to go up with the boom, get your sail set, all that other good stuff. I'm back. We're going to go ahead and rig the mast. This is so simple, it really doesn't need a tutorial, but we're going to do it anyway. All you have to do bring it up here to the gooseneck. Set the pin. Then come forward to where you have the topping lift on the cleat on the trailer. Pull that out of the cleat and lead it aft. And in this case, you want to make sure it's clear of the spreaders. Bring it back here. Thread it through this pulley at the end of the boom. Thread that through clam cleat here on the mast. Pull it all through. A lot of excess. Thinking one day I'm going to trim this off, but not today. I put a pulley with a swivel on here, and I think I'm going to take it off because more often than not, it twists up and makes this more difficult than it ought to be. So, if you're thinking of putting a pulley where your topping lift comes through, forget it. It's easier if you don't have one. Alright, so you come in, you tighten that off. Go ahead. Lead off your main sheet, and that way this doesn't swing around and make trouble for you when you're rigging the boat.